Another reason is as Christians, if you look around the things that are going on around our nation, our state, our city, are just atrocious. I mean, we've had women speaking in matters that are just insane, to say the least, in regards to abortion. That's a very hot topic right now. We have individuals that don't believe in the sanctity of marriage, and, as the Word of God states, it is between a man and a woman. And these are individuals that are in powerful positions, of authority within our government. And this gives us an opportunity as church members, as individuals of this community, to actually speak to the individuals that are actually running for office. Now, I'm going to say this briefly, and I'm going to try to move along because I want to make sure that we stay within the time constraints, out of respect for the candidates and everyone else. Running for office is a very, very tough thing. You need to understand that when these individuals actually take that step, they're not opening just themselves to actually be scrutinized, but their families. They're actually, their families are going to be stolen away of that particular family member's time. You know, if you get elected, your time with your family is not going to be what it is now. So I appreciate that, and I'm grateful for you. My wife one time asked me not to run for office, and I'm honoring that. And you know, she gets enough headaches from me as a pastor. That's okay. But I say that to say this, is we are to pray for these individuals, right? Because their commitment is to us, especially individuals that actually believe in the blessings that God has bestowed upon America, the wisdom that God gave the forefathers of these nations when they established this great, great thing that we call the Constitution of the United States of America. I personally believe that that is inspired by God, because I don't think man is that brilliant. So, that being said, I'm going to ask the candidates, one at a time, to please come up. I'm going to give you 4 minutes so that you can briefly introduce yourself. What office are you running for? And a brief question is why? I mean, that's a question that I think doesn't get asked a lot, and is a very important question. Why in the world would you put yourself through everything that you've already gone through and what you will go through? But know that our prayers are always with you. So I'm going to start with Brother Marcus. Brother, if you wouldn't mind coming up here, sir.
Thank you guys for having me today. It's a blessing to be able to be here. I just rushed over here from another event, so I'm a little hot and sweaty. Why am I running? Because I believe very firmly that so many of our people are being led astray right now. We've lost so much. We've lost a sense of family. We've lost a sense of community. And all of that comes from good Christian and church values. Our values are what not only guide us, but they guide our nation. And because these values are now so lacking, we see every day some new, very interesting thing that is trying to be passed into legislation or decisions that are being made for all of us, which is being taken away from us as a sovereign individual. Okay? Sorry, guys. All right, so for me personally, I can't say that I'm always going to be somebody that all of you agree with all the time. I can tell you 100% that I'm going to do my best to carry on the message that was given to me for the Lord to carry on to all the people. I'm going to tell you that I'm going to do what I believe is best in my heart and is best to follow my values that have been given to me by the Lord, by coming up in church, and by doing my best to fellowship and see what the common man needs. Because at the end of the day, it boils down to what is needed by the common man. Our elected representatives have forgotten that, and they've forgotten that the majority of us care about our neighbors, and all we want is unity. Every day we see more and more disunity and disharmony pushed and sowed every single day. I'm tired of it. I'm a person that's for unity, not division. I'm for actions and policies, not thoughts and prayers. We've prayed. We've thought. Now we need our elected officials to take action. But they're not. And those thoughts and those prayers without action are hollow. It's time that we stand up and we say that we will have no more of their false promises, no more of their hollow thoughts. Yep. And that's why I'm running. I have dealt with so much to run and run with values and integrity. Sometimes I use a little bit of profanity. I'm working on my potty mouth, you guys. But the message is true, and the message is from my heart. And I hope that everything that I say and everything that I do, that you guys can say, you know, that Marcus, he's a genuine person. He means good. He will do the best that he can in service of us and in service of our state and in service of our nation. And most of all, in service of the Lord. Thank you guys for having me. I won't take up too much of your time. You guys be blessed, be well.